As we've learned, a mood board is the visual representation of our brainstorming session. It also lays the foundation for the overall theme of our design. The first step to building a mood board is to think carefully about the feelings and associations you want to convey. You could start with some descriptive words, like fresh, light, airy. Including these words in your search can help you find the right mood board template to start, or use them to add inspiration later on. Let's find a template. Begin by searching for a mood board from the homepage. As you can see, there are lots to choose from, so having some idea of the style you're looking for will help. You can also use the filter on the left to narrow it down. Now that you've chosen a template, we need to start adding our inspiring content. The Elements tab contains just about every ingredient you can think of in Canva, so try searching for a keyword here. And remember, you're not limited to Canva elements. When it comes to mood boards, the World Wide Web is your oyster. Try searching Google, Pinterest, or other sources that might inspire you. Or better yet, go out into the world and take your own photos. Upload your own photos from the Uploads tab. Or search and add a photo by dragging and dropping it straight to your page. To replace photos, just drag and drop a new one into a frame or over an existing image. It might help to include other perspectives too. Why not invite someone to collaborate with? Use the Share button to invite other people to your design, like this. Then, start adding to and populating your board in real time. Or, leave comments on elements like this. Use your inspiration to create a color palette for your board. Find suggested colors based on your photos in your swatches, here, making it easy to draw color inspiration directly from your mood board. You can then create an entire color palette by adding swatches to your board by coloring shapes like this. Refine your mood board by grouping inspiration into clear themes or categories. You could also try listing your descriptive words or values to help categorize your elements. It's also nice to prioritize elements on your board to show important elements. Make a key image larger to create levels of hierarchy within your board. This will give your board focus and clarity. Lastly, it's important to always keep your mood boards handy during the design process, as this will become your North Star when making design decisions later on. Share them with your clients. Download them or print them out. Designers often stick them on a wall to easily reference them all the way through the design process.